introduction of DNA into bacterial cell. Okay, this is what we are going to discuss in this video. How you introduce DNA into a bacterial cell. Now, the transformation is a process by which bacterial cells uptake naked DNA. Okay, when bacterial cells uptake naked DNA, the process behind that is known as transformation. Now, there are two methods for transforming a particular bacteria. Okay, first is chemical transformation and the second one is electroporation. Okay, so these two are the methods for transforming a bacteria. Now, let's discuss about chemical transformation method. Okay, now the bacteria which are able to uptake DNA are known as competent. Okay, what are competent bacteria? Competent bacteria are those bacteria which are able to uptake DNA. And bacteria is made competent by chemical treatment. Okay, you treat bacteria with some chemicals and after that bacteria becomes competent. After that bacteria becomes able to uptake the DNA. Now, competency is a physiological state. It is a physiologic state in which there are changes in structure and permeability of the cell membrane so that the naked DNA can enter into the cell. Okay, in this physiologic state, okay, in the competency, the permeability of the cell membrane of the bacteria, the structure of the cell membrane of the bacteria changes. And that is the reason why this naked DNA is able to enter the bacterial cell. Now, this chemical transformation method utilizes CaCl2 and heat shock to promote the DNA entry into the cell. Okay, the chemical transformation method utilizes the use of CaCl2 and heat shock, and both of these promotes the DNA entry into the cell. In chemical method, the bacteria is incubated with DNA on ice-cold salt solution which contains CaCl2, and this is followed by heat shock at 42 degrees Celsius. Okay, you take your bacteria, you take your DNA that you have to put into the bacteria, you incubate this bacteria with DNA on an ice-cold salt solution, and that salt solution also contains CaCl2. And after all that, you give heat shock to this solution at 42 degrees Celsius. And after that, okay, after all this, the DNA enters the bacteria. So there is a tube. You put your bacteria in it. Then you put your DNA in it. And then the solution of this tube is a salt solution, which also contains CaCl2. And after that, you give this tube a heat shock at 42 degrees Celsius. So what happens because of that is the DNA present in this solution enters into the bacteria, which is also present in the solution. Okay, and that is how the transformation takes place. Now, how exactly this treatment works is not understood. But it is assumed that this CaCl2 might cause the DNA precipitation on the surface of cells, and that is how the DNA enters into the cell, or the salt present in the solution changes the cell wall of the bacteria, which improves the DNA binding. Okay, this might be possible, but it is not fully understood yet. Now, the competency can also be achieved through electric pulses, and that process is known as electroporation. Okay, with the help of electric pulses, the competency is achieved, and this whole process is known as electroporation. Okay, so this electroporation utilizes a short pulse of electric charge to uptake the DNA. Now, this electroporation produces microscopic pores in the biological membrane. Okay, and this microscopic pores in the biological membrane, which are produced by electroporation, are known as electropores. And this electropores allow the exchange of molecules, the exchange of ions or exchange of water through the membrane. Okay, so this is how the electroporation method works. It just makes the electropores, and through these electropores, the DNA will enter in the cell. So that's all for this video. Okay, so by doing chemical transformation or electroporation, you introduce the DNA into the bacterial cells. Thanks for watching. See you next time.